Hello, this is Eric Bobrow. In this ArchiCAD video tutorial, we'll explore how you can show pictures, paintings, and sculptures in your 3D model. This question came up when a client of ours, Steve Nickel, wrote to me about an exhibition that he heard described in Shunome, Jared Banks' blog. Now, Jared described how an art exhibition was shared by BIMX, Graphisoft's very powerful tool for sharing 3D models with people who don't have ArchiCAD. So he wrote a post last year, and then he wrote another post actually just a few days ago, February 21st, 2014, about the National Museum of Sweden and how they're sharing their exhibitions in 3D. So you can see a current exhibition that they've got available as a tour on BIMX. Now, I opened up the original file, which was for an exhibition last year, and I'll show it to you for a moment here. So in this exhibition, you can see that as I move around, it looks like the paintings are on the walls. So that's really quite lovely. You can see there's a cutout of a human figure here to give scale. Now I'm going to navigate by using the forward arrow, and you can see how as I move into the next gallery room, there's what appears to be a sculpture. It looks quite realistic. Now, as I get past it, and I'll sort of move deliberately to the side of it, and then rotate to look at it, you can see that it really is a cutout of that sculpture. But from many angles, it looks quite realistic. Certainly, it helps to give a sense of scale and communicates quite nicely. Now, Steve asked, how can you do this? And also, he asked, where do you get pictures like this if you wanted to put pictures into an ArchiCAD model? Let's take a look at how you can do this in ArchiCAD very, very easily. I'll just draw a little wall here, zoom in a bit, and I'll put an object. Now, the objects library has a perfect element, has the word picture as part of its name. And so when I type that in and hit the Enter key, you'll see how ArchiCAD will search for objects that have that name or have that description. So here's the one called Picture 17. There'd be similar ones for ArchiCAD 16 and 15 and going on backwards many years. And it basically shows a frame with an image. Now, what type of image will this be? Let's just put this up, say, at a reasonable level off the floor, and I'll pop it in here. And we'll look in 3D and zoom in. And perhaps many of you are quite familiar with this picture that's a classical painting. Now, I'm going to go and select this and drag a copy of it. Say, let's just make sure that I'm dragging it in a straight line along the x-axis here. Now, when I go and open up this picture, there are some parameters, and I can expand them, and there's an option to use a custom picture. Now, as soon as I turn this on, it changes the image here, and it allows me to put in a picture name. Now, let's just see what it does when I say OK. Well, oddly, it gives an error message because the one that's in the default library, which is called picture1_10, is no longer in the ArchiCAD library. So Graphisoft has a default parameter here that causes an error, which is a little bit funny. But we can easily work around that. I simply go to the File menu, Libraries and Objects, Library Manager, and I load in another file. In this case, I'll take a picture that I shot myself with my iPhone of a sunset. And I'll just say that I'd like to add this to the library. You can see how it shows up in the embedded library. And I say OK. Now, having done that, it still has the error just because of this 3D view hasn't been updated. But I'm going to now go in here and change this from picture 110 to sunset. Now, I put in just the name of the file, but not the .jpg, so not the ending with the dot and the three letters. And it will then show this picture. See, there's my sunset. Now, it's a little bit out of proportion. If I press down here and stretch it, you can see how it'll stretch out. In fact, I could stretch it, way too long. In this case, it might still look sort of okay, but obviously each picture will have a native sort of proportion, and that would be something important if you want it to look realistic. Now let me just drag another copy here along there, and let's look at some other variations we can do. I can go and stretch this taller, of course, and maybe I'll stretch it down to the floor level. And we'll look and see that there's an option for the picture frame to make it detailed or simple, or you can turn it off. Now let's look at the difference between simple. So simple here, you can see this shape, whereas when I select this one, you can see how it has more ridges. If I undo the change here, you can see how this is more complicated than the simple version. But now I'm going to actually go and turn the picture frame off using this little pop-up here. And now you'll see that the image actually jumps out to take the whole space. So that wouldn't necessarily work for this image, but we'll explore how we could use it for other types of images. In fact, I'll take one more option here and just drag another copy. And this time I'll look at a parameter that says the tilting angle. So if I say tilt it 90 degrees, it'll lie flat, but in this case it's lying sort of face down. So let me undo that and go in here and tilt it, say, minus 90 or 270. And now it's lying on its, you know, where we would see the image. But of course it's sort of fallen behind the wall. Now this image here could be something like a carpet. So if you had a carpet picture, that would be an interesting way to display it. Now you can select this here, and it's got a certain thickness. Right now it's half an inch thick, or about a millimeter or a centimeter, I guess, something like that. If I make this say zero in thickness, then it will be, let me go in here. This is the thickness here. So this would be the zero, and you can see how it now becomes just paper thin. So those are some options that you can do. Now, in the exhibition, there were pictures all over the walls. They came from obviously shots of the artwork that is in that gallery. So that was pretty easy for them to do. They had to maybe model some more ornate frames, or at least put pictures of those ornate frames in there. But if you wanted to put in some pictures that were maybe, you know, not of this classical gentleman, but something else, then maybe you would want to do some research and get them from the internet. So if you did a search for something like Van Gogh painting in Google, you'd see that not only does it show you some paintings up here, but information down below about Van Gogh and his paintings. If I click here in the Google area for images, then it just shows me images. Now you can go and grab any one of these. You can click on it, it'll expand, and then you can right click and say save this image, and it will then save that as a JPEG file or whatever format it was. If you're concerned about the legal right to do that, if you are going to be putting this out publicly, then you might want to click on search tools, and then when you click on that, it opens up usage rights, and you can pick pictures that have been labeled for reuse, non-commercial or possibly commercial reuse like this, and that will give you, you know, somewhat smaller choice of images, but still plenty of images that we would see here. Now I've saved one of these images in myself already. You can see this Van Gogh image here, and I'm going to go and add this into a picture frame. Very, very simple. So I'll go back into ArchiCAD. I will go back to the Library Manager. Now at this time, instead of loading the individual image, I'll add the folder of images that I've got, and say that I'd like to choose that. So now it's going to have that as a linked library. I can also then, because I already have Sunset in that, I'm going to remove it from here, and then I'll say OK. So that will reload the libraries with all of the images in that folder. And then if I go in here, perhaps I might take, this is a custom image, and type in Van Dash Go, I think is what I had it as. And you can see now we've got this lovely image, which I'll just stretch out a little bit here to make it look a little bit more the proportions that it should be. So you can see how easy it is to put in artwork if you want to dress up your model. Well, what about if it was a sculpture? What if it was something like what we had in that exhibition? Well, Steve Nichol, my client, suggested, when I asked him, can you tell me what sculpture you'd like. He said, well, how about the statue of Poseidon from the Greek Museum? So I did a little quick search here for the Greek sculpture of Poseidon, and you can see here it is, or there are different ones, but this is the one that he meant. And I scrolled down and looked through them and found one like here that is straight on. So what we want is an image that is straight on, so at least from some angles it will look, you know, natural. Now I've saved that here as Poseidon, like that, and I've opened it up in Photoshop. So one reason to open something like this up in Photoshop is because it's got a lot of other stuff there, and the first thing I'm going to do is just crop it. So I will expand this out a little bit, use the marquee tool within Photoshop, and sort of carefully draw a box around this, just barely large enough to contain the artwork. And then I'll use the image menu crop command, which will cut it back. So now I can go and say save as, and when I do that, I can choose, for example, Poseidon-cropped, and it will now have a variation here that is, you know, this cutout very close. Now, if I go back to ArchiCAD and go to the Library Manager here and use the option to reload the libraries and apply all the changes and then say OK, then I will have that available, and I can go, for example, and take this vertical image here and change it instead of from the sunset to say Poseidon cropped. You can see how it's now the picture that I was looking at. Let me go and stretch this out. In fact, actually, to make it, I think, 6 feet tall, but not quite 2 meters, and we'll stretch this out to be a little longer here till it's, you know, maybe looks like it's about the right proportions. Obviously, if you paid attention to the exact dimensions of the image, then you would get it in a good proportion. Now, it is a nice image, but it really is not a cutout like we had for the sculpture. So let's explore how we can do that. I'm going to go back into Photoshop, and I'm going to turn this into something that's not a JPEG. In Photoshop, there is the concept of a flat image that's in the background, but if I double-click on the word background here in the layer list, then I can just change it, and we can just call it sculpture. Now, by changing it, it changed from this an italic look to normal text, and it also made it eligible for being removing part of it instead of it having a solid area. So let me demonstrate that. I'm going to use the lasso tool, and I'll just very quickly go and draw sort of very crude box around the sculpture, just to demonstrate the concept without taking too much time to do it precisely. So I'm outlining the sculpture very roughly. And now if I were to hit the delete key, you'll see how when it deletes it, it's deleting the contents, which we, of course, we don't want to delete that. We want to delete the other part. So I'll undo that and then go to the select menu and say select inverse. Now it hardly looks any different, but now it's selected the inverse part of the image, and if I hit the delete key, you can see how it will, you know, show certain parts solid and certain parts with this sort of funny checkerboard pattern, which is Photoshop's way of indicating that there's nothing there. So in order to save this out for use in ArchiCAD or any other program for that matter with the transparency, I need to save for web and devices in Photoshop and choose a format instead of JPEG, which would give me a solid white background. I will choose PNG-24, which gives me the transparency. And I'll just go ahead and say save this Poseidon, and instead of cropped, we'll call it Poseidon cutout 1. And now let's go back to ArchiCAD, reload the library. And we'll change this image here to be Poseidon cutout 1. Now all of a sudden we're seeing the image of the sculpture here, but we're not seeing through it. We're seeing this sort of funny brown texture. Now what is that texture? That texture is actually the material or surface of the picture frame, which is this walnut. Now, we don't want a picture frame, and we don't want this surface to show up at all, so let's pick something that might disappear, like glass, clear glass, and I say OK. Now, you can see it looks much better. We're seeing through it, but as we get in close, you can see that there is a slight difference. The glass is not fully transparent. We're not seeing through that. So let's go and create a cutout, or let's create a material or a surface that is fully transparent. Go to the Options, Element Attributes, and go to Surfaces. Now, this was before ArchiCAD 17. That was called Materials. Now it's called Surfaces. Now, in the Surfaces here, I'll look for the glass clear, and let me duplicate it. And I'm going to call this Empty, and I'm putting in an asterisk at the beginning so that it floats up to the top of the alphabetical list. You can see how it's right near the top now because it alphabetizes with that special character at the beginning. Now, glass is partially transparent because the transmittance is set at 60% in this case. I'll take it up to 100%, and now you can see the preview has changed. When I say OK, we're not seeing a change immediately because I have to actually tell this object, instead of using the surface that is glass, that I wanted to use that new one that I just created called Empty. And say OK. Yeah, now that's much better. You can see that it really does blend in. There's actually no nothing opaque there. Now, we have two problems. Obviously, the outline is very crude, and the other is that we have this box around it, at least two things that are not doing what we want. So let's go back into Photoshop, and let's look at an option that we'd have to clean this up. So I'm going to step backward in terms of here. So we're now starting back where we have the whole thing, and I'll switch the marquee to a magnetic lasso. So with the magnetic lasso, as I start working on this, you can see how it just gravitates or is magnetically attracted to the edge. So with just a little bit of care, I can get a good result as long as there's a good contrast between the artwork and the background. In this case, we have most of this image has a very strong contrast to the background. Now, I'm not going to worry about doing it too perfectly because I'll show you how you can adjust that if you make a mistake or you want to fine-tune it in a minute. So I'll just go around. You can see how, in this case, it's able to do a pretty darn good job with very, very fast results. Now, remember, when I finish this, the area that it's selected is what's inside, so I want to select the inverse. And instead of actually deleting it, which would mean that I couldn't tweak or fix the boundary, I'm going to use a different setting, which is under the layer menu. I'm going to say that I'd like to create a layer mask and hide what's selected. Remember, I inverted it, so the selection is the outside, so I'll hide that. Now, you can see how a beautiful image there is, but there is a little problem here that I want to fix. So I'll just zoom in on this, use the magnifying glass. Okay, you know, you can see that there were some dark areas in the background of that picture, and the magnetic lasso wasn't able to do as good a job right away. So you can see that in the layer preview here, here's the full image, and then here's this black and white silhouette. When I click on it, that is the mask that we're looking at. And when we work with the mask, if we take a brush and we sort of brush across this, you can see that even though I'm drawing black, it actually is erasing the image, and it actually put black across there. Let me just undo that here. I'll just hit the undo, and if I just go along the edge here, you can see how I can remove parts of this. So I can just ever so carefully do this. If I flip it around in terms of this black and white, then you can see how I'm actually bringing back in parts of the picture, you know, which is not what I want to do, but I just wanted to explain that. So let me undo that. Let me just bring back maybe a little bit of the edge here. You can play around with the size of the brush. You can make it bigger or smaller using the brush controls in Photoshop. But ultimately, this is a pretty good image, pretty good copy that I've got. I think I don't need to do anything more for this demonstration. So I'll go now and under the file menu say save for web and devices, and we'll say it's PNG 24. Go ahead and save, and we'll do Poseidon cutout, and I'll just give it a different name, cutout 2 here. And go back to ArchiCAD, and we'll select this, and we'll tell it that we'd like to use Poseidon cutout 2. Now actually, I can't do that right away. I have to tell the library manager to go reload the library so it can find that. This is a little bit annoying when you're creating new pictures, but it's necessary if you're doing things that ArchiCAD might not know about. So now I put that in, and look at that. That's quite beautiful. So now we have something quite clean here, it would work quite well. We do have this solid border around it because, after all, this is a rectangular picture. It's just showing only certain parts opaque. If we were to look at an elevation drawing, we're also going to see that we see the picture frames and we're seeing this cutout. So how could we have it where it's got a silhouette, where it looks nice in 3D and in an elevation? Well, let's take a little side detour and put in a figure. So this figure here, this figure tool, allows me to go and select and open any picture image that I want. So I could take the sunset image, or guess what? I'm going to take that cutout that I had and say open it. Now when I say open it, it shows it here in a preview. It allows me to set the size. I'm going to say that it's probably 6 feet tall. That would be a good size. And I'll make sure that I say transparent so that when I place it, the areas that were transparent in Photoshop will show through. And when I say OK and click, you can see how it comes into position. Let me go and select it. We have to maybe find where the boundary is here, and then I can drag this into position wherever I want. And you can see how it looks quite nice. Now, there is a little bit of a problem, and that is that it's actually behind all the line work here. So I need to go and use the display order, bring to front, and now you can see it looks more natural. So if you want to bring in a human figure or a tree, a car, or a sculpture into an elevation, this is a perfect way to do it with the figure tool, using a transparent or a figure that has transparency turned on. Now that didn't resolve this particular issue here, because in fact this element here is not showing in 3D, it's only showing in the 2D drawing of the elevation. So how can we get it to stand up like that in a 3D view? Well, let's take a little detour to understand textures and origins of textures. If I take this wall here and I change its surface, what used to be called the building, the material, but here I'm going to go and say that I'd like to make these surfaces have a particular appearance. So this is concrete masonry units, they're blocks. Now notice that this block starts at the bottom, but we're not getting a whole block here. If I were to drag this wall over, say if I just drag it, you notice that it actually looks like it moved in, that the block stayed constant, but the wall shortened. Actually, I wasn't shortening it, I was dragging it. But what ArchiCAD is doing is it's creating this sort of theoretical field of blocks and then just displaying it on top of the wall, wherever the wall happens to be. In fact, if I change the wall bottom, if I say take the bottom up to 4 inches or something like that, you can see how the block stayed constant and the wall just shows a different part of it. Now let's look at how we can set the origin of the 3D surface material. So I go to the design menu and say align 3D texture and set origin. So I've got this wall selected. I'm going to click on the corner here. Now you can see it's got a whole block here. If I drag the wall like that, you can see how the blocks move with it. If I change the wall to start at 4 inches, you can see how this all moves with it. So I've locked in the relationship of that picture that makes it look like it has blocks on top of the wall. So regardless of where I move the wall, it'll stay in that corner. Now what we want to do is something similar with a texture. Now in this case, we have a picture map. We have an object with a picture map, just like we have these ones within frames. Let's create a material or a surface similar to the blocks, but using this sculpture image. I go to the Options menu, Element Attributes, surfaces. Remember, before ArchiCAD 17, that would be materials. And I'll pick something that just has something that has a picture image that's more complicated, like this stone image here. I'll duplicate it, and I'll give it a name, Poseidon, with an asterisk here, so it floats up to the top of the list. And this texture, I'm going to search for a texture. Instead of using one of the stone ones, and you can see there's a lot of different choices, I will look in the image folder and pick out that nice cutout that I just did. Now, it looks a little bit funny here in the preview, but from my experiences, that it will actually look just fine here as long as I turn on transparency. And I don't need the bump mapping. That would try to make it look like it was standing out based on some parts of the image. So transparency will give me something that will look good. I need to set the height of it so that it's going to be proportional. And we've now got a texture that we can use as a surface. Now, here's the vectorial hatching. I want to turn that off. I want to have no fill. Let's see, just something like airspace will do, so that when it's shown in a view where it can't show a picture, it's not going to try to show some funny line work. I'll say OK. Now, that is something that I can now apply to a surface. So if I go to the wall tool, and let's just say that I draw a piece of wall, and let's maybe make this wall not as tall. So we're going to say that it's not linked. So in ArchiCAD 17, the tops of walls can be linked to the next story, but we don't want it to be linked to the next story. We want it to be something that we can specify, and I'll say it's 6 feet high. And perhaps I'll go and make this, instead of being a complex thing, I'll just do it as a simple one. And what happens if we were to make this, say that, okay, this is the building material here. Let's go into the surfaces and say that I want to override this. So this would be basically in, before ArchiCAD 17, the material. In ArchiCAD 17, we have to say, I want to use a special surface attribute. And let me just lock this and put it in as empty. Now, I do empty, you can see it shows through it. But what happens if I put Poseidon? Ah, look, there we have Poseidon showing up. Now, it's not lined up at the corner properly, but you know how I can deal with that. I can simply grab the design menu, align 3D texture, set origin, and put it at the corner. And now you can see Poseidon is starting right here, and it looks like I made it just about the right length. It's just barely past his finger. I don't need it to be as thick as this, so let me go and change the thickness from 8 inches to 2 inches or something like that. So now it's going to be a simple little piece. So now if we, you know, move around, it looks quite similar, these two, but we now have it on a little piece of wall. So you may be saying, well, but that looks no different. We still have an outline. And if we go to the elevation, we still have this piece of wall just as a rectangle. We're not seeing the actual cutout. So now we have to do one more step. So I go back to the floor plan, and I'm going to use the slab tool. And I'll draw a slab, say, with the vertical dimension. Let's see, we'll just go maybe 7 feet long, and the vertical dimension 6 feet. So I know that it's tall enough for this Poseidon image to be used. So I've got this selected. We're going to just make it a simple material, and then override its surfaces, choosing a new surface material here. And guess what? We'll just pick here Poseidon. And now if I go to 3D and we zoom out a little bit, there is Poseidon. Now, it's sort of an interesting little thing that we've got Poseidon on all sides there. Let me go and select this, and we'll use the Align 3D Texture Set Origin here. And let me make this, let's just, instead of doing it for all of the sides, let's unlock this and maybe make this bronze and the underside bronze, so that it's, when we do a cutout, it's actually just got a simple surface there. And we'll make this not quite as thick. We'll just make this 2 inches thick or something like that. So now it looks a little bit better. Now it's a little bit longer than it needs to be, so I'll go and pull this edge back here like that. So now we've got something that's sitting here. Now why would I want to do that? We're still seeing it just as a box. Well, I'm going to flip this up. Before I demonstrate the final result, I'm going to select this and show you how you can flip this element to stand upright, and then we'll do a cutout of the slab, because remember, you can have the slab can have a complex shape. We can cut this out. So let me go and only show this slab. So I'll say show just what's selected in 3D. You can do that on the floor plan, or you can do it in the 3D window after selecting certain things that you want to look at. Now I'll go to the view menu, 3D view options, 3D projection settings, and choose that I'd like to look at it in a parallel view from the side from 90 degrees. So that's going to look at it from sort of straight up and down, or straight from the top of our drawing down. And we'll see now we're looking down on it. Having done that and selected it, I can go to the File menu, Libraries and Objects, Save Selection as Object. This allows me to save the current view of the selected object as the floor plan view of the new object. It's going to rotate it around so this actually is the matches the model. So I say OK, give it a name, and we'll call this Poseidon Sculpture One here. And you can see how it remembers the surface, that it's got Poseidon on one side, it's got bronze on two of the other sides. So we don't have to play around with that, but let's just see what that does. When I go to the floor plan and I go to the object tool and click, you can see how there is this thin little element that's been placed that's looking on this from the back of this model. If I go to 3D and say show everything in 3D, and zoom out and zoom around, you can see that we've got that element. It happens to be floating up in space because this was set up at 3 feet from the original picture. I had the original picture 3 feet off the ground, and it's actually set in reverse. So just because of the way that it saved it, I need to turn this 180 degrees, rotate it around, and now you can see what it looks like. So what I've done is I've taken this slab and I saved it as an object. Now it still doesn't have the answer that we need. We need it to be a cutout. But here's what we do. We cut this around. Now in order to see it, I'm going to go and take that figure tool and drop in that figure. It still remembers the last figure that I was working with. I'll just drag this into position here and take the slab. So you go to the slab tool and select the slab here, and I can go and we'll just subtract out and take a polygon shape here. Now I'm going to do again something that just demonstrates the concept. Let's see, do a subtraction of here. So I've just cut out a couple of pieces. Let's see what happens if I go to 3D with just that element and take that same, as we'll take our view again to be a side view from 90 degrees azimuth, and then save. And we have to select it first. Make sure you have it selected, then go to the File menu, Libraries and Objects, Save Selection as Object, and then we'll call this Poseidon Sculpture 2. And now I go back to the floor plan and I place that object here. And when we go to 3D and take our view, see, go back to our previous view and say that we want to show everything in 3D, you can see that we've got this piece that matches that shape. And if I turn it around the 180 degrees, we've now got this with a bit of a cutout. Now, it's not a good cutout. So we can just take the time to cut this out very, very carefully around that, and it's going to look good. I've done something ahead of time that will make it easy. I actually placed a similar picture here, traced it with the slab tool. You can see this is a slab, and then I traced that, or used the magic wand to trace the slab with a fill. So I'm going to copy this, go back to our model that we were working on, and paste it in. So when I paste it in, this is a fill, and I'm going to go and let's say take this and drag it on top of here until I get it sort of about the right position, and take that and we'll just line it up. It's almost perfect as it stood, but we'll just get it just a hair down. Zoom in a little bit like that. That's probably about as good as I can get it right now for that. Now this is just a fill here, so it's just a 2D graphic. You can see it's a fill here. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the slab and remember that subtraction? Well, instead of doing it manually, I can use the magic wand. So I'll press down the space bar, magic wand, and there the slab basically traced the fill and cut out everything outside it. Now, if I go to that in 3D, you can see I've got this cutout. And if I take my view here, and again, take this side view from 90 degrees now azimuth, and then select it, and libraries and objects, save selection as object, and we'll call this Poseidon Sculpture 3 here, and then we go back to floor plan and replace this new object that I've just saved. We'll place it over here and say show everything in 3D and go to our view. So you can see that this is now a nice cutout. We'll flip it around to the 180 and we'll place it down at the floor level. And you can see now we have a sculpture. So I can get rid of all these other experiments here and end up with just a nice little sculpture. And guess what? When I go to that elevation, there we have it. In fact, it was almost exactly in the same place as I put in the figure. If I drag this, you can see that the figure and the outline are not quite lining up, but that would be something that you could easily, you know, get to work out. So we now have an option for showing it in an elevation, showing it in a 3D view, and of course, as we explore this, whether it's inside ArchiCAD or using BIMX, it looks like we have a sculpture. I'm going to show you one more variation. In ArchiCAD 17, we have the option, actually in 16 and later, we have the option to use the morph tool instead of creating an object. So I'm going to drag a copy of this over like that. Whoops. Let me just drag this as a copy here. And let's just make sure I'm going to put this to zero thickness here because I want to convert this to a morph with zero thickness. You could actually have the morph with thickness. Now, for those of you who aren't familiar with the morph tool, it's a very flexible tool for creating shapes. And one of the things is that you can select anything that you created, whether it's a wall, a window, a piece of furniture, something that you've imported. You can go to the design menu and say that you'd like to convert what you've got selected to a morph. When I do that, it says the selected elements will be converted into morphs and the original will be deleted. It is now, you can see, it looks very much the same, but with a little green border on it. Now I'm going to go drag this over in this area because one of the things that I can do with the morph tool is I can rotate the morph freely in space. So if I press down on any point on the morph, there's an option to rotate it. Now if I use this rotation on the floor plan, we can simply rotate it around, you know, lying on the floor. But I can use that same option to rotate and then go to an edge of something like this wall, and it's going to go perpendicular to that. So now I can say I'd like to rotate it from horizontal up to the y-axis, and you can see now that actually is exactly placed in there. Let me just drag this now, you know, forward. So this is now, I didn't actually have to make it into an object. I could literally just turn it into a morph and then flip it up. Now, one advantage is, you notice how there's some slight mistakes here in terms of the shape. I can go in and with the morph tool, say I'd like to move this point, and I can actually move this point down, and I can, you know, play around with these shapes. You know, maybe I want to make this finger stick out a little bit more. So this looks like maybe it needs to change shape a bit to do that. So I'm actually can edit this here in 3D, this morph. So that is one reason why doing it as a morph tool potentially could be better. We also can flex, play around with how thick it is. If I go to the back of it and I press down on the morph, there's an option. Let's see, it looks like this morph is maybe because I did tweak that. Let me just undo those couple of steps here. Now it's flat. I had gotten it slightly out of flat, and I can actually make it thick. So I can boost this up. I can just thicken it right on the fly like that. So you can see how it's now got whatever thickness I want to put in there. So those are some options that you may want to use for creating the sculpture. You literally actually could do that in the elevation. So if I go to the south elevation, and let's say that we had, this is the morph that I've just done, and here is the figure. Well, let's just go get that, let's go to the floor plan and let's copy that figure. Go to the the fill tool. So I'm going to go to the fill tool, select this fill. So I'll copy this, and I'll go back to that south elevation, and I'll paste it in. And maybe we'll just move it around. I'll just drag it up to approximate position here. Now this fill is just a purely a 2D element. Now I can actually use the morph tool in 3D and use the magic wand and trace this. And you can see how now we have a morph. Now where did it show up in 3D? If we go into 3D, you can see how it showed up here. Now why did it show up here rather than where the other ones were? That's because on the floor plan, the elevation that I was looking at is here. So the morph that I just created was created exactly in line with that elevation. So if you want to create a cutout directly in the elevation, create an elevation or a section or move it close to the elements. Then when you do your trace, that's going to be there. Now, we can just drag this into position. I can go and drag it anywhere I like. And now if we go back to 3D, we're going to see here's that morph element. So if you don't want it to actually be a sculpture, if you want it to be more like just a human figure that is a silhouette, then you can use either the slab or the morph tool and have just a shade, maybe a black or a gray, to indicate that. And in fact, if we were to make this something like a glass, let's pick this, and we'll just say that I'll make it a glass. Or it may be a tinted glass here. You know, we can play around with what it appears. Let's use the airspace one. You see here, air is one that was provided inside ArchiCAD 17 that has an interesting sort of subtle appearance there. So those are a number of ways that you can bring in 3D pictures, either your own photo, artwork here, you can put in carpet, if you have a picture of a carpet, and if you wanted to create a sculpture, while you can use the picture object, you can also bring in your own image and carve it out on a slab or in a morph, and then with a slab turn it into an object that you can stand upright, or with the morph you can literally just stand it upright, directly. Now there's one last thing I forgot to show you, which is just that there is an object in here that, you know, if we go into the picture one, that's called people bitmap. Now with people bitmap, if I go and select, you know, man standing like this and I pop this in, let's just pop it in over here, you can see it has a symbol on the floor plan. If I go to 3D and we zoom out a little bit, there is that man standing. And it looks quite natural. It's floating up off the floor again. But it still has that rectangular cutout. So Graphisoft has provided some nice images for this, and they will look good in certain contexts, but they, in a rendering, in fact, if we go to the document menu, creative imaging, rendering, photo render projection, then that person is going to look, oh, there's a sketch one. That's an interesting one. Let's just go and change our photo rendering settings to, instead of a sketch, just to our normal Lightworks, and then we'll render that there, and we'll see, we'll go to document, creative imaging, actually photo render it, and now with the Lightworks one, we're going to see that the person bitmap, as well as these sculptures, all look good. But in a 3D window, obviously, or in an elevation, they're not going to look the way we might like. You can see how that human figure just shows as a rectangle. So those are some things that hopefully you'll find useful. This has been Eric Bobrow. I hope you enjoyed this ArchiCAD video tutorial. I look forward to getting your comments and questions on the page down below. Thanks for watching.